Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti UNVR Instant. It's an all-in-one network video recorder running Ubiquiti's UniFi Protect and UniFi Access. It's got a PoE switch in there with 40 watts of power. It's got an HDMI out, so you can plug this directly into a monitor. You can use that HDMI because it's a Ubiquiti View Port to configure how the screens want to appear on it. This will take a 3.5-inch hard drive as well. And like I said, it's got a 6-port PoE switch with 40 watts of power. So a really good all-in-one network recorder. This is not a technical overview. We've got how-to guides, how to set up UniFi Protect, how to set up UniFi Instant, the NVR Instant over on our YouTube channel. So head on over there if you want that. But this is about what you get in the box. So let's head on in. So not masses of stuff to get in the box. And start off with your drilling guide. You can see we've got our level on here and our holes. Let me just show you on the bottom of the unit. We've got these feet on here at the moment. And this plate actually slides off. So if we just take the plate off, we actually can see here that we can drill through these holes here using the guide that we've got. And then that will actually allow us to mount that directly on a flat surface if we want to, which could be useful if you've just not got much space in the cupboard where you're wanting to actually fit this. Or maybe you've got this out in the shed and you want to just put it into a cupboard or something like that out of the way. All right, what else are you going to get? So others are going to get what's called a DIN rail mount. You might have these in your electrical cupboard, a way of just clipping the device on and in place. You'll actually see on the back here that we have got a little hole here. We've got a nodule on the back of this. We've got a screw in this packet here. And that will allow you to fix that, obviously screwing from the other side, fix that in place, and then that allows you to then clip that down over your DIN rail and again mount it like that. Obviously with your PoE ports then pointing downwards. So that's that. You are going to get a packet of screws and lugs if you want to obviously hard surface mount that. You're going to get your get started guide, which you probably won't take out of the packing. You're going to get a fastening screw. On the side of the unit here, we've got a screw that once done up nice and tightly will stop you being able to slide this plate open at the bottom and make that more secure. And you're going to get your power cord. It's just a standard figure of 8 2-pin. We're here in Australia, so that's our fitment at that end. We should have one for your area. And then you're going to get the unit itself. So let's work round the outside of this first. You can see we've got our cooling vents. On the front here, we have got our LCD panel, which has a few lines of display of showing you how this unit is traveling. Like we said, on this side here, we have our screw to fix the base plate in place. And then the bit that probably most people are wanting to have a look at is this. So like I said, this is 40 watts of power, which doesn't sound a lot, but most of the cameras you're going to probably plug with this, maybe you're going to have only 5 or 6 watts of power. So you've got plenty of power in here. This is just standard PoE, so it only can give up to 15 watts of power per port, but that should be pretty good. We've got 6 1-gig PoE ports along here. We've got a 1-gig Ethernet port uplink, no PoE on that one. Obviously our power in and our reset hole over on this side. And then we've got our HDMI out, which is actually a viewport. So this is not just an HDMI that you can just plug into a TV, although you can and have the screens displayed directly there. But the HDMI port is great. You can have multiple configurations of what cameras you want to be displayed in, what order, have them scrolling through other cameras as well. So really good option to have that on here. Now this as a unit, I think it takes 15 HD cameras. I think it's like 8 2K and like 6 4K cameras. So you can get a good balance of the number of cameras that you can run on this. Then obviously like we've done, we've gone inside or the bottom of this before. So we're just going to pull the plate across and take this off. And now we can put our hard drive in here. So let's put it this way. This is designed for a 3.5-inch. It's got some nodules here to allow you to clip into the normal screw holes of your drive. So you can put it in, push it down and clip. You first want to leave this lever up so that it clamps into place and push this down, which just gives it a little bit of extra friction to hold that in place. You'll see there's a retaining screw here, which you can use the screw provider or a screwdriver to just do that up and fix that into place if you want to. I'm not sure totally what we're gonna have as maximum capacity. I'm pretty comfortable to say, as long as it's a standard 3.5, I reckon you're gonna get multiple tens of terabytes of storage hard drives in there without any problem. Like I said, this is designed for a 3.5. Obviously you can see that a 2.5 would fit. And I'm sure with a bit of packing and ingenuity that some people, I'm sure very shortly, will be able to put 2.5 inch in there as well. But you will need to just check. I'm not sure whether it supports SSD or not. You know, some people, I'm sure, will experiment on that, but it is designed out of the box for a 3.5 inch hard drive. Well, that really is what there is to the unit. A fantastic all-in-one. Like I said, this can run UniFi Access as well. So UniFi Protect and UniFi Access, if you're wanting to be able to have a whole little ecosystem of Ubiquiti connected together, you've already got a router or something like that already, or maybe you're using this as a remote location, this could be an ideal solution for you. So hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more unboxings of network firewall, wireless and security, how-to guides as well. So why don't you subscribe and stay up to date?